Hello, horror lovers. I'm Lacey, and I love horror and I love making lists. Today, I have 10 more modern creature designs from horror films. I am still working on more Buffy content, but wanted to maybe do a shorter video while I'm working on the longer ones. So here we are. If you enjoy this video and love horror, be sure to subscribe so you know when I'm posting new content. And if you have any requests for future lists, or creature designs that deserve a place on this list, comment and let me know. I love receiving horror recommendations as much as I love giving them. For now, for this list, I'm still just working on film designs from the last 10 years, but I will be exploring more classic designs as well as creatures featured on TV, comics, and video games. I'm also issuing a huge spoiler alert for this video, as I will likely be discussing certain plot points while discussing the designs used in the films. Alright, let's get started. First up for number 10, I picked the creature from The Boogeyman released this year. This film is based on a short story written by Stephen King and takes place mostly after the events from the original story. The Boogeyman is about a mourning family that's being preyed upon by an entity that feeds on its victims' suffering. Depicted as a large and lanky monster with multiple arms and fingers for a jaw. The jaw actually opens to reveal another face within. With the title Boogeyman being an umbrella term for monsters in the closet and under the bed, I really liked they took the opportunity to create a unique design. Coming in for number 9, we have the Aztec goddess Itzpapalatl from 2021's No One Gets Out Alive. I couldn't put Modare from Ritual on the last creature design list without putting this design on the next one. Based on the novel of the same name, written by Adam Neville, who also wrote the novel that the Ritual was based on. And just like Modare, Itzpapalatl's design is disturbing and stunning. She's the goddess of death, and she enters our world through a stone box used as a portal, and she's incredibly hard to describe. So I'm reading this from an article I found by Laura Gislason. Ambar is set to be the next sacrifice, and we're treated with a spectacular entrance from Itzpapalatl. A massive arm emerges from the box, and then another. As the creature pushes itself free, we can see it resembles a woman draped in a veil made of skin, with the train gradually becoming more wing-shaped as it drags along the floor. The veil is shaped like a crown or a head of hair, like a person laying down. She walks on those giant hands with a second set clasped together toward the floor, almost as if in prayer. These secondary arms are also under the skin veil. Climbing atop two blocks and set into a wide stance, she lowers her hands and gently caresses Ambar's face. We're also shown a close-up of the goddess with the layer of skin taut over empty eye sockets and the mouth wide. To me, this looks like a death shroud. She also has a mouth in her groin area. Keith Thompson was the creature designer for both films, and you can truly tell that they belong in the same world. For number 8, we have Gabriel from James Wan's 2021 film Malignant. Starting out as a similar plot to the hilariously terrible Basket Case, Gabriel was born as a parasitic twin attached to his sister, Emily's back. As children, Gabriel was surgically removed from Emily's body, but in order to not do damage to her brain, they had to leave a little of Gabriel's behind. He lied dormant well into Emily, now going by Madison's, adulthood. Due to an abusive husband, Gabriel is awoken and starts to control Madison's body, seeking revenge on those who took a part in his demise. He does this by splitting the back of her head open to reveal a gruesome face, then operates her body backwards. It's a fantastic and outrageous film, and I love it. Number 7 is the creature designs from Terrified, or Alterados, an Argentine horror film released in 2017. This movie is worth the subtitles, trust me. A group of scientists and an overwhelmed police officer investigate a series of supernatural events plaguing a neighborhood in Buenos Aires. It's hard to pick just one design from this film when every single one is unnerving and terrifying. There's the sort of reanimated corpse of a young boy, a tall entity living under a man's bed, and tons of other twisting and contorting apparitions. Even the scientists mutilated bodies walking around makes this film jam-packed with nightmare fuel. Number 6 is Jean Jacket from Jordan Peele's Nope that was released just last year. Jean Jacket is an incredibly unique design for an alien. While at first it looks like a flying saucer, it's revealed that this is actually the creature itself. After sucking up victims for food, you get to see what it's like inside the creature. Their horrified screams can be heard as it flies around in the sky until they're finally cut short when digested. The characters are able to destroy JJ by treating it like they would any animal. Alright, number 5 is The Mutants from 2019's Lovecraftian horror, Color Out of Space. There are a lot of reasons to love this film. A meteor crash landing and infecting everything around it, the devastating mutations created from the spread, and Nick Cage. Watching the family one by one be infected by the meteorite really is painful, but we're here for those mutants. The hideous amalgamation of llamas is amazing, but the Teresa Jack is a fate so much worse than death. After being consumed by the color with Jack in Teresa's arms, the two are fused together but still alive, and seemingly in large amounts of pain. By the time we see them again, they've lost their humanity completely and start to attack Lavinia. Number 4 is the creature from 2020's Sputnik. A parasitic alien hitches a ride to Earth in the esophagus of a cosmonaut. It looks unique while also seeming familiar, and the film does a great job making it so you're actually rooting for the alien and his host, Constantine. For number 3, I picked Allie from Hatching, released in 2022. This film is definitely more about the family, but that doesn't mean the ever-changing Allie doesn't deserve a shout-out on this list. Always being goopy and slowly transforming to look like Tinya, the girl who was caring for her. When she's so similar that even her mother can't tell the difference, she aggressively starts brushing Allie's hair until she rips out part of her scalp. Allie then attacks her with her mouth tearing open at the sides. Tinya saves her mother, but also protects Allie, who at this point is a perfect copy of Tinya. Number 2 for this list is the puppet from 2018's bleak and atmospheric film, Possum. A disgraced puppeteer moves back in with his genuinely awful uncle. He's also hunted by the creation he had made called Possum, and while he tries to dispose of the puppet multiple times, it always seems to come back to him. This design in this film really stuck with me for days after I watched it. The puppet is uncomfortable to even just see in photos and advertisements, but honestly, that just made me want to see it more. They were also very smart with using the less is more when it came to the puppet. The design was inspired by the uncanniness of doppelgangers combined with the fear of spiders.
I am just jumping in here to add an honorable mention of Grim Cuddy, which premiered on Hulu back in 2022. This is not a good design, this is a hilarious design, but I just thought it deserved a place on this list because I feel like I know what they were going for. I just feel like it failed and just looks mostly ridiculous, and just wanted to add it as a little lighthearted humor for this list.
My pick for number 1 is several designs from VHS 94 released in 2021. After VHS Viral ended up being a dud, many fans feared that the VHS franchise had fizzled out. But the release of VHS 94 revived the series, and two more films have been created since its release. Standout designs from the film include Rathma from the segment titled Storm Drain, the reanimated corpse from The Empty Wake, the cyborgs from The Subject, and the unique and terrifying vampire from the last segment, Terror. Seriously, even if you haven't seen any of the other VHS found footage anthology series, you need to check this one out. Alright guys, that's all I have for this video. If you enjoyed it and you would like to see more, don't forget to like, subscribe, and follow. And if you would like to place requests for entries on this list or requests for other lists, please comment below. I love to hear from you guys, and I love receiving recommendations. Thank you to everyone who watched this entire video. Thank you so, so much for watching. It means so much to me. And I will hopefully see you guys in the next one. Bye.